Tonight, the New York State Senate is expected to take up an up or down vote on making marriage legal for same-sex couples in the state of New York. Republican State Senate Majority Leader Dean Skelos released a statement saying, "This is a very difficult issue, and it will be a vote of conscience for every member of the Senate." Earlier today, Governor Andrew Cuomo and the state's legislative leaders reached an agreement on language that would protect religious institutions, which paved the way for tonight's vote. Only 31 out of 62 New York State senators have publicly endorsed the marriage equality measure, which is now one vote short of a majority. The new language agreed to today is aimed at Republican senators who say they oppose the measure on religious or moral grounds. If the bill passes, New York would become the sixth and the most populous state to allow same-sex marriage, doubling the number of people in the nation eligible for same-sex marriage. Joining me now is Richard Socarides, the president of Equality Matters and former White House senior advisor to President Clinton on gay civil rights issues. Richard, thank you very much for joining me tonight.
Thanks for having me.
Andrew Cuomo has made this his priority. I have not seen a governor take this on the way he has, and with this single-minded approach to getting this thing done. Well, is that why we're where we are tonight?
It's certainly one of the reasons, if not the main reason. And, you know, we haven't seen anybody in American politics really ever, certainly no straight politician, take an issue on like this. I mean, but he has really made it his signature issue. And early, you know, he during his campaign, his recent campaign, he's only been governor for about 6 months. During his recent campaign, he said this was going to be important to him. He said he was going to work on it. But there was a meeting right at the beginning of March. A small group of us were called up to Albany in secret the day before, and he surprised us. And he said, "I'm going to work on this as hard as I've worked on anything in my life. The time for this is now." And he very smartly knew that the time to do this was early on in his term when he was popular. His numbers are very high, his favorability numbers that are so important, and he knew he could get the legislature to go along with him right now. So it was very confident, very capable political leadership is the number one reason for sure that this is happening now. The other two reasons, of course, are that we see the public opinion has shifted nationally, but that shift is even more dramatic in New York, and the gay rights groups really got their act together. Governor Cuomo said to them at that meeting that I was at, he said, "You have got to work collaboratively, you've got to work cooperatively, there need to be no missteps, there need to be no hiccups, we need to do this kind of in secret." I mean, you know, it wasn't like a secret plan, but it was an under the radar plan, and that's another reason why he was so successful at it, because he was able to do it without alerting the right, without alerting the anti-gay groups early on that this is what this was his plan. But if he is able to pull this off tonight, and we think he will, we think we've probably got their own, we're one vote short of publicly committed people, but we think we've got 33, 34, maybe even 35 votes. He will be able to, if he can pull this off, he will be able to pull off this bipartisan, you know, we wish it were more bipartisan, but it is bipartisan because the New York legislature is a divided government. He will be able to pull off the first bipartisan legislative victory for same-sex marriage, a very divisive issue in American politics, and we think it'll be a really real turning point, certainly a momentous moment in the history of the gay rights movement.
And what Democratic Governor Cuomo has known he was going to have to do from the start is reach across the aisle. This couldn't be solved by Democrats with Democrats. And when we look at Washington politics with the focus that we always have on Washington politics, it's become kind of unimaginable in this country that that could happen, that a Democrat could sit down, close the door with Republicans and reason with them, which it sounds like that's what he's been doing.
Well, he's reasoned with them. I think he's probably had some old-fashioned arm twisting too, and I think perhaps maybe on a state level you can negotiate for that highway probably in somebody's district, something that you're familiar with in your previous career a little bit in some of those tax bills. But what he was able to do is do it in a very self-confident way. And what he realizes is that this was an issue of conscience, that you could reason with people of good faith if you could have a discussion with them. And yes, he's pulled it off. And the leadership he's shown on this, you know, we've talked a lot this week because President Obama gave that speech to the DNC, to the gay part of the DNC last night, and where he kind of, you know, President Obama's decided he kind of wants to have it both ways on this, right? He wants to be neither for it nor against it. He's evolving. But the political leadership we're seeing Governor Cuomo show is really extraordinary, and we hope that President Obama shows some of that.
I got to have you come back and talk about President Obama, because what fascinates me is the amount of tension he gets on this subject compared to the president you worked for, Bill Clinton, who I think seemed to escape these pressures while doing a very different job. Barack Obama's done much more and had to undo some of the things.
Yeah, well, that was 20 years ago, right?
Yeah, I guess it is
a difference. 20 years can.
But I do want to hear the analysis of how those two presidents.
I'd love to come back and do it.
Richard Socarides, thank you very much for joining me tonight.